All right, guys. So we have several things that we need to get accomplished today. Number one, we need you to route signal through this console. Number two, we need you to set up an overdub session. Number three, we're going to discuss miking techniques on electric guitars. And then finally, how to document those sounds so that we can reproduce them later if we need to. All right, guys, what we're going to do is just double check, make sure that the microphones are positioned properly on the speaker, and to make sure that the capsules are as even to the speaker cone as possible to, if not eliminate, minimize any kind of phase problems we might have. So let's just take a quick look. It's always nice to have a flashlight handy so that you can actually look inside. And both of these mics are actually placed right on that crease where the dust cover meets the cone material. So this one's good, and so is this one. Let's take a look at the fender. The fender is going to be a little bit more difficult. You're going to have to get way down here to double check. But this is the way and the only way to do it accurately. And we're good. You've even made sure that the capsules between the ribbon and the 57 are pretty much right on the money. We're going to adjust the XYs so that it's approximately at the 12th fret, or again, where the neck meets the body. It's usually the sweet spot. I do like to push up a little bit on the acoustic, but then again, one of the problems with that too is you push up too much, you're going to lose some of the stereo image you're trying to gain by doing a stereo miking technique. The space pair, same kind of thing. I'm going to basically point it right at that sweet spot. And then this one, I'm going to do more by ear than anything else. And like anything, if you've never recorded something, use your ear, find the sweet spot, put the mic in the sweet spot. One thing I am going to try and do is try to get the mic's approximately the same distance away from the guitar. Like if you were right there, right in front of the acoustic guitar, right? Yeah. Right there. Thank you. All right, guys, let's take a listen to some of these microphones. Now, a lot of the microphones that we're using have been used for years. These are industry standard mics that have been used not only for recording studios, but for live sounds for several different reasons. We'll start off with the SM57. The SM57 has, as you can hear, a lot of mid-range bite. It doesn't have a ton of bottom end, doesn't have a ton of top end, but that's okay. That's exactly what a guitar should sound like. It shouldn't have too much bottom end, or it's going to get muddy with the bass. It shouldn't have too much top end, or it's going to get brash and brittle. It works very well. 421. I like using the 421 a lot. The 421 has a little bit more bottom end and a little bit more top end, as you can hear. The two actually complement each other very well.